has been commandeered by the secret society No Man, National Organization of Men Against Amazonian Masterhood.
I slept with a lot of dudes. I don't know.
Yeah, you did? 135?
Fellas. If your lady tells you something like this, or something even remotely close, it's cool, dude. Just bring her back to where she belongs. The streets, homie.
Your son said he loved me. Like a 13-year-old, look.
He's really mean.
Wake your ass up, G. I'm at your mama.
The guy I'm dating is, I'm still paying my own bills, paying for my own hair, my own nails, every...
Now that that experiment is done, you women have proved what men have been saying all along. When I posted this video about cooking and cleaning being life skills and not gender roles, men pushed back by saying that women do not want to be traditional women anymore, but they still expect men to provide. I legit ratioed all the men who said providing was not a gender role because I thought women had an understanding of this, but technically we do not. We legit prove their point that women still want men to provide, but they do not want to be traditional women, quote unquote. Pause and read, but some of them were like, no, you should always have your own money, but you should use his as much as you can. Therefore, that's saying I want the perks of being a modern independent woman, but I still want a man to provide in that traditional role. I was called masculine. I was called a pick me, and I don't give a damn. I'm always gonna speak the truth. Pause and read. But yes, the men were right when they said that women want the financial independence that comes to being a modern woman, but they still want men to be traditional.
Say no envelopes to open, I just do it cause I'm supposed to, nigga.
You can really see the hurt boys in the comments, but like I said, my grandma died before I was born, so I had a rough life.
I need y'all to shut her down. I want her mouth closed permanently.
I take what's mine and take some more. It rains, it pours.
Yo, if your girl ever wakes up in the middle of the night and she tells you that she can't sleep, pack your things and leave ASAP because her body's still used to those 2 a.m. sneaky links. Trujulations, 6933, stay woke, Kings.
She belongs to the streets.
She said, no numbers saved. It's like I said, I'm about to worry, we need a cancellation. She right here. She right here, G.
I don't owe you. That's my purse. Dating
today goes part 5. It's so hard to date these days, I am just so picky. Well, what is your type? I like tall, athletic guys who are funny, smart and sweet. That shouldn't be so hard to find. I don't think it is hard to find, but you are 5'4 and weigh 40 pounds more than you should at your height. Why does he need to be athletic? You aren't yourself. It's just what I like. What else? I also want him to be good looking. I wouldn't mind if he made a nice amount of money. That's weird because you work at Starbucks and you're 32. Don't you think you're setting yourself up for failure? Even if you met this guy, What could you offer him? What's stopping him from skipping right over you? I'm a sweet girl with a big heart. So is the 22-year-old version of you who's fit and better looking.
So somebody tagged me in this because they seen a video where I was just talking about this. And that's why you don't let your girl have a best friend. That is a male. Notice how he broke that touch barrier, completely grabbed her on the waist, slammed her on the bed, and then crawled on top of her. That's okay, right? There isn't a guy alive who watched that video and been like, that's fine. If that's my girlfriend, that's her friend. Not at all. So now let's change the roles. Would it be okay if that was my girl best friend? You know, my girlfriend would be okay with me doing that to her? No. That's why it's advised. And notice how I'm saying this for all you people in the comments. Most of the time, it is not okay for a girl or a guy to have friends of the opposite sex like that. It's just not. You know who is your best friend? Your girlfriend or your boyfriend. That's it. That's all you need.
I'm an independent woman, and that's why y'all don't like us.
No, what?
That's why y'all don't like us, because we can do it ourselves. We don't need y'all.
Ma'am, we want y'all to be independent. What the fuck are you talking about?
What do you mean?
If we want y'all to not depend on us, pay for your own shit, and sometimes go half and half, what the fuck does that mean?
Well, I mean, if you're broke, just say,
oh, so now I'm broke?
I just believe a man should just pay for everything.
So what the fuck do you want? Do you want to be independent or not?
You don't even know what the fuck you talking about,
no,
man.
No,
Shut the fuck up.
I tolerated so fucking much in the past 2 fucking years from these niggas. Fuck that, we gonna start this bitch now. Yeah.
What the?
This one looks pretty good.
What is your definition of a real man? Don't lean on her shit.
Okay.
Use your own words.
All right. The definition of a real man for me is a man who does what he says he's going to do. He's a provider. He's loyal. He's a...
don't make it look obvious.
A great father. Hard worker. Shit. And take care of me, like, on every level.
So someone that's logical, dependable, money smart, I guess is selfless. Like, when I am not thinking, like, women are always thinking of men, like, did you eat today, did you do that? I want someone to do that for me.
And those
make sure I'm good.
Fellas, y'all realize most of these definitions revolve around servitude?
No, it does not.
It revolves around giving.
Selfless.
Like, yeah, I'm going to give myself to.
Fellas, if females ain't going to like this one right here, whenever that day come, if that day ever come, when you get that phone, no matter how you got it, if she gave it to you, she sleep, or whatever the case may be, don't go in and look for dude names or contacts or pictures like that. Nah, you don't do that. What you do is you go in the messages. You find the best friends, the sisters, her mama. Everything you want to know, I'm going to be right in there. Thank me later. Now, females, tell me I'm lying. Tell me I'm lying.
How it be after the breakup after she cheated? I hate you. I still hit. Only lasted 10 seconds, and I still hit. But did I? Unlike you, my new boyfriend make me. I don't care, still hit before him, he got my leftovers. You couldn't even hit my G-spot. Guess what? What? I still hit. That's why it's so small. And I still hit. Am done with you. I don't care, I still hit. Why start body shaming when I didn't disrespect you? Stay mad, I don't care.
I don't care if he talks to other females because...
Lick me, lick, tease me, touch me, please me.
And y'all still gonna validate them, huh? Y'all see, these females are giving you their game. You can't react to it. Every female get that type, even the ugly ones get that type of attention. So what? So what? Don't say, oh, if I talk to someone else, she's gonna replace. No, she's not. And if she does, owe the fuck well. the fact that you show that you don't care, right? The fact that you can't give a fuck will make her want you more. I promise you. Remember, who has the most power in a relationship? The person who cares the least. The person who cares more has no power because they care too much about losing you. They care too much about the relationship. They're too relationship focused. Just don't let that person be you. Stop validating females, you fucking thirsty beta simp bitches.
Woke up, got down, now I'm feeling like that. I can't listen to a word you just said.
If you love that penny hop, bitch, take off your panties, hop. Glocker end up fanny.
Bro, I legit thought I was the only one. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, I like ass. I'm a guy. I like ass. But can y'all do something different? Like, this shit getting boring as fuck.
Do not refer to me as a slut ever.
Real men don't rape.
Oh shit,
must have been a ghost then. Consent is sexy. Lingerie is sexy.
Shut up, bitch.
I don't know you. That's my purse.
Dude, if you are cis, dude, please don't use the fucking gender-neutral bathroom because then it's gonna second only use that one.
I wasn't expecting her to fuck somebody else. So when I got back with her the other day, she dropped the bomb on me. I said, did you have sex with anybody else by the 10 days we wasn't with each other? She said, yeah, I did. You're a fucking slut. You're a slut. And if it wasn't because of me being a stand-up dude, I would have had you lock her ass up and put her the fuck away. Goddamn, 10 days.
Your girl is not going to leave you to be lonely. I don't give a fuck if she married or not. Unless you force her hand, like you beating on her, or you like it's an abusive situation to where she's threatened, or you kick her out, she's not going to leave you to be lonely. 100, I would say almost 9 out of 10 times when your girl break up with you or she divorce you or whatever and she move on, before she did it, there was another guy. I can guarantee you that women are not going to leave you to be alone unless you were overbearingly, you know, abusive or some shit like that.
She was very gorgeous to me.
The generation's trying to feminize men.
Oh,
and most women, really, and even the women act like that. Women don't want a man who's feminine. Like, let's keep it 1,000. And women's core DNA, they want a man who's masculine and who, I'm not gonna say control them, protect them. Like the painting nails and wearing handbags. Women will support that shit on social media, but in real life, they're not dating these type of niggas. Who are they, baby daddies?
Oh,
masculine, aggressive.
You being this passive male
just doesn't work.
I'm telling you right now, it's not gonna work.
They're like, how old are you? And I'm like, oh yeah, 18, turning 19. Because nobody wants to hang out with a fucking 17-year-old.
Yeah, because that's illegal. And if they care about your age like that, it's because they're trying to fuck you, dumbass. What?
No, that's not true.
Bruh.
They just want to be friends.
Chat, this is society nowadays, bro. Take your nose, boys. This is what I'm talking about. They will lie for anything and say, oh, they're trying to be my friends. The fuck? The guy's trying to fuck.
They are my friends. What do you mean?
He's trying to dig in those, bro.
No, he's not. He's literally my friend. He came up to me and asked for my Snapchat because I looked like a cool person. That's what he said.
Chat, you can't make this bullshit up, bro. You really can't.
Girl, it's bad out here. It's really bad. But one thing I have to say is, anytime I...
you want to talk about it? Let's talk about it, because I want all of the smoke today. So, black men, most of the black men you've encountered are broke, right? Cool. So, and you said that you've gone over to another race and they had money. All right. Now, my real question is, why didn't you stay the fuck over there? Or better yet, here's the real question. Why the fuck did they not want to keep you? Because I can answer that for you. Because if you are a bitch to us and you are a bitch to another race, you will still get treated the same. Left lonely. And I don't know damn well y'all ain't talking about us being broke. Half the time, y'all ain't got no car. Y'all got a roommate. Y'all over here got a fucking sugar daddy trying to pay for y'all lifestyle because you don't want to work. Don't talk about us being broke. And y'all definition of broke be some bullshit. Like, oh, if he got an ugly car, he stay in the hood. And he don't have that much money to spend on me, he's broke. And it's not the fact that most of these men are broke. It's the fact that you were looking for a retirement plan and they don't give a fuck about you.
Yeah. Hey. Hey. She lie to your face. I really don't get it. She say what you want her to say. At the end of the day, I'm still getting money regardless. I'm
back again.
That's right.
I'll see you later.
Hey, hey, fuck your homie, he dead. No, hey, fuck your homie, he dead. Hey, fuck that head, he dead.
You been talking to other girls? Nah. They been talking to me. That's too much sauce.
But these hoes mad, hoes mad. I think I fucked up best friend, a cousin. I got these.
Bitch on me tricks. I don't really beef with a nigga about a bitch. Lil' hoe got Molly, she poppin'.
By the way, well, let hold on on it. And by the way,
I need y'all help. We gotta find bro and tell him.
No. No, no. Say you swear to fucking God, bro. Bro, this is not real, dog.
So you mean to tell me a woman is gonna say this to you? You know, I didn't mess with you 10 years ago because you was broke and you was ugly. But now I'm older now. I'm out of shape. I got 3 kids and I don't look how I looked in my prime. So I like you now because you look like you can take care of me and you can take care of my kids. So now I want to talk to you. You really think a woman's going to tell you that?
Hey, boy, this hoe got me fucked up. This hoe talking about she finna stay tonight because it's too much snow on her car. Bitch, please. Oh, you got to go. You got to get your ass on. We finna slip for this, bitch. It's time to go. I don't give a damn how much shit out here in Florida. Shit crazy. Hey, boy, the hoe talking about, can I stay tonight? I can't see. Don't worry about it. I got a place for you. Get the fuck out of here.
Get the fuck out of here.
Slipper, slipper with the towel. Gotta go home.
Ladies, why is it that you'll ignore facts and logic, but you'll listen to rocks and space to tell you the truth about things? You're stupid. It's a thin line between love and
hate. It's a thin line. She's not even wearing a bathing suit.
Oh, no, sir, not even close.
No, that's a piece of fabric with a string going in between the
buns. Matter of fact, ain't that the bathing suit you told her you ain't really like?
She bought it anyway.
Oh, so your feelings don't matter.
Everybody just breathe.
How about we stop you from breathing?
Coward. She just wants to feel sexy.
Feel sexy for who?
She got him. Oh, what? Who called him?
Yeah, that's my cousin, though, so watch how you speak.
She's
about
at a pool party in Oakland, California. That's a 20-minute drive from here. We can make it there in 10.
No, guys, listen, I just think that we should all just compromise.
Thank you. I got priors. Guess we're going to jail. Guess who's going to jail. Guess who's going to jail tonight.
women. Maybe you were made fun of when you were young.
There, believe me, every man out there has been hurt by women. That's what men have in common there.
You're hosting a radio show about it.
Yes, I am. It's about time. Because every TV and radio show is about women. And it's about men are jerks, men are pigs, men are slobs, men are deadbeats. Now there's a show for men. We're taking back the power.
Men like you are.
You are nothing but a talking vagina. You have nothing else going for you. You have with a, yes, that's what you are, a talking vagina, dear.
Listening to all these idiots call in and sit there and brag about their girlfriends doing, waiting for them.
There you go, using another term on the air you know you can't use, you and your filthy mouth.
All these girls, you're the one talking, filthy mouth. You have a dirty mouth.
Really? What did I say that was so dirty?
Basically, you have no respect for women.
I have no respect for you, dear. Don't get those mixed up.
You have no respect for any woman.
Believe me, any woman who stays home and cooks my dinner and fillets me on a regular basis has my utmost respect.
Which you probably don't even have.
Oh, really?
Unless you're paying someone.
Oh,
really? You should tell your callers who want that, give them the number to an escort service.
Oh, see that? There you go. And dear, what is your husband's name?
What's my husband's name?
Yes.
Johnny.
You're not married.
Yes, I am.
You made that up.
I can't even say, why would I make it
put
up?
Put him on the phone.
Johnny. I'm not with him right now.
All right, give us his number. We'll call him right now.
No.
You made him up.
My husband.
You are not married. You're 23. You're not married.
I'm married.
No, you're not.
I have nothing to prove to you. I was born in the
And you, if you are married, believe me, if you were married, your husband would be putting a bullet in his head right about now by having to listen to your mouth. Another one of those mouthy broads I always talk about. That's you.
Happily married.
Oh, yeah, says you.
Says him.
Says you. Everyone. He's probably porking your best friend right now. Where is he?
He's probably porking my best friend. Where's your girlfriend? What about you? Do you have a girlfriend? Do you even have anybody to sit
yes.
there and make your dinner?
I have whatever I need, believe me, darling.
On a radio station?
I have whatever I need because I'm famous and rich.
I'm famous and I'm rich.
Yes.
I've never even heard of you until driving a car.
Dear, I don't care what you've heard of. Here you are now. You know me now.
Yeah, I guess I do. Anyway, well, good luck to this little career that you have. And
well, this little career that I've had for my entire life since I was 14. Yeah, I know. This little career I have with a seven-figure income, like with money you could never dream of.
Well,
la, 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 that's the best you can do.
Joke,
by the way, you still haven't told us one of the top five news stories. You don't know what's going on.
Well,
you couldn't tell me one of the top five news stories of the past year,
I'm
for Christ's sake.
Yes, I could.
No, you
yes,
couldn't.
Could.
You could not.
Yes, I could.
No, you can't.
Okay. You're not going to try and get a rise out of me. I called to state my opinion.
I got a rise out of you already, dear. You already served my purpose.
Hey, she said she went to Burger Mill.
That'll be $9. Excuse me, sir. It's not she. It's they.
Where's the other person?
I don't think you understand. I'm not a she. I go by they.
Okay. Well, that'd be $18.
Whoa, sir, you just said that I had to pay $9.
Yeah.
She would have to pay $9. They have to pay $18. Okay, I'm not sure if you're trying to be sarcastic, but my pronouns are not she. My pronouns are they.
You know what? How about both of y'all get out my store?
Both of who? Both of who?
Why your friend just moved? What y'all trying to get into?
What friend? Who are you talking about?
This guy right here is exactly why guys tell their girlfriends, listen to other dudes, because we can spot a creep way quicker than y'all can. Because dudes who post stuff like that for female validation all the time, they don't believe any of that. They're doing it just to get in your pants. And it's sad to see that he has over 100,000 followers that are probably like 90% women that can't even see he's doing this for likes and views or female attention because he can't get in real life.
This may be the end of No Ma'am for now. But it's not the last you'll hear of it or me.